Now, encoders in general are used to convert one code to another. So, talking about encoders in general, so there are 2 power n number of inputs and n number of outputs. So, any encoder will have 2 power n number of inputs and n outputs. So, in this session, we will discuss a priority encoder. So let's talk about a 4:2 priority encoder. Now let us assume that since the input is 4, there are 4 input lines. So let me assume that there are 4 lines, I3, I2, I1 and I0. And there are 2 outputs, Y1 and Y0. Okay. So in a general encoder, if I0 is 1 and all the remaining 3 inputs are 0, I get 0, 0. Next, if I1 is 1 and all the remaining 3 are 0, 0, we get 0, 1. If I2 is 1 and the remaining are 0, I get 1, 0. And if I3 is 1 and the remaining are 0, we get 1, 1. So this is the working in general of a general encoder. Now let's talk about priority encoder. Now, assuming that there are 4 input lines, we can assign priorities to the inputs. Now here, in a general encoder, it is with the assumption that I'm getting the input data at one of the inputs. Either I get 1 at I0, or the data at I1, or at I2, or at I3. Now if I get the input data simultaneously on 2 or more lines, then what do we do? Now suppose I1 is 1 and I2 is also simultaneously 1, then the question is, what happens? So in such a case, we can assign priority to the input lines. Now assigning priority to the MSB, so this is the LSB and this is the MSB, that is line 0 to line 3. Right? So assigning priority to I3, it means that if I receive data on the line I3, irrespective of whether I receive information on I2, I1 or I0, I only consider I3. So the highest priority is attached to I3. So if I'm getting data on this particular line, then the information coming in all the other lines are invalid, or they are not very important, right? So the information along I3 coming on I3 is considered. So next, we assign importance to I2, right? Because the priority is from I3 to I0. So if I get the data or information on I2, I1 and I0 remain, don't care, right? So I only consider I2 irrespective of whether the information is coming on I0 or I1. So next, what about I1? If information is coming on I1, I0 is don't care. And of course, I0 has the least priority and this has the maximum priority. So if I have to receive information on I0, it is true that there is no information being received on either I3, I2 or I1, right? So if I receive information on I0 and all the other 3 being 0, the output is 0, 0. If I receive information on I1 and I2, I3 being 0, irrespective of I0, it is 0, 1. Receiving information on I2 with I3 being 0 and I0 and I1 being immaterial, the output is 1, 0. If I receive information on I3 which has the highest priority, then the information coming along I2, I1 and I0 is not considered or is immaterial, where the output is 1, 1. Right? So therefore, I can also have another output which is known as the valid output. Right? Now, if the data is 0, right, then the output is invalid, isn't it? So this again is 0, 0. The output is invalid. And here the output is valid. Okay, so the output is valid with y0 and y1 0 only when I receive data on I0 only, right? When I don't receive any information, then of course y0 and y1 will be 0 0, but it is not a valid output, right? So now how do we design this? Now this can be designed using a k-map, right? So let's try to find the expression for y0. Now y0 is 1 for this combination and for this combination, right? So let me write the combinations here. So I have 0, 0, 1, x is either 0 or 1, right? And I have y0, 1 for 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, with I3 being 1. So for all these 8 combinations also, which is represented by 1xxx, y0 is 1. So y0 is 1. So y0 is 1 for these combinations. So let me draw the k-map, a 4 variable k-map here. So we have I3, I2, I1, I0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, right? So what are the cells? So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Right? So we are writing the expression for y0. So y0 is 1 for 2 and 3. 2 and 3. And for 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Right? So what can I combine? These 8 ones can be combined together. And these two can be combined together, right? So combining these 8 ones, what happens? I1 and I0 get eliminated because they are complementary. And here I have I2 which gets eliminated because I2 is 1 and 0 here. So I have I3. So there is I3 here. So what about this? So considering these two columns, in these two columns, I0 is complementary, so I have I1. Considering row 1 and row 4, what is complementary? I3 is complementary. I3 is 0 here, I3 is 1 here. So I have I2 bar. Okay, so what is Y0? Y0 is I3 plus I3 bar I1. So now let's write the expression for Y1. So Y1 is 1 for these two combinations, right? So the combination for these two combinations, I1 is 1. So the last combination we have already seen, it is 1xxx. Okay, so 1, that is from 8 to 15. And let's talk about this. So you have 0, 1. So this I1 and I0 can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, or 1, 1. For these four combinations. Okay, so for values 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 5, 6, 7 and for these 8 combinations y1 is 1, right? So writing the K map once again. So I3, I2, I1, I0. Okay. So the expression for Y1 is 1 for 4, 5, 6 and 7. So this is 4, 5, 6, 7. Right? And then these two rows, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So combining these 8 ones and combining these 8 ones, so the expression for this. So what gets eliminated here? These four columns, I1 and I0 get eliminated. And here, considering these two rows, I3 is complementary, so I have I2. And combining these two, for these two, I2 is complementary, so it is I3. So Y1 is I2 plus I3. Now we also have another output, which is the output. Whether the output is valid or not. Now this is 1 for all the combinations, isn't it? This is 1 for all the combinations except for all 0. Right? So except for all 0 combination, which is this, it is 1. Okay? So now we have already combine these ones. So let me combine these 8 ones and let me combine these 8 ones again. So the expression of this is I2 and I1 are complementary along the 4 rows. Considering these two columns, I0 is complementary, I have I1. Considering these two columns, I1 is complementary, so you have I0. So the valid output is I3 plus I2 plus I1 plus I1. So we can design a priority encoder, 4:2 priority encoder, with the priority given to I3, with the maximum priority given to I3 and the least priority given to I0. Right? So now let us try to do the design for a 4:2 priority encoder. If priority is given to I0, maximum priority given to I0 and the least priority given to I3. So let's see what happens. Right. So maximum priority is given to I0 and the least priority is given to I3. So the first case, all zeros, output is 0. It is invalid, so the valid output is 0. When I0 is 1, maximum priority is given to I0, irrespective of the inputs I2, I1 and I3, we consider I0 0, 0, output is 1. Next, if I1 is 1 and if I0 is 0, don't consider I2 and I3, so therefore you have 0, 1, output is 1. The next is I2. If I2 is 1 and I1 and I0 is 0, I3 being don't care, we have 1, 0. The output is 1, the valid output is 1. And I3 having the least priority, if this is 1 and all the other 3 are 0, Y0 and Y1 is 1, 1. You have 1 here. So now I need to design for Y0 and Y1. Okay, so now let's see the expression for Y0. Now Y0 is 1 for these two combinations. Right, so let me write these two combinations. So we have XX10. So it can either be 00, 01, 1011. And then you have 10. Right, so this is for XX10, right? So you have Y0 is 1 and Y0 is also 1 for the last combination, which is 1, 0, 0, 0. So y naught is 1 for these 5 combinations, right? So K map so I3, I2, I1, I0, so this is 3, this is 6, this is 10, and this is 14, and this is 8, right? Okay, so this is cell 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So I have a 1 for, I'm sorry, this is 2, 0, 0, 1, 0 is 2, a 1 here, and then 0, 1, 1, 0 is 6, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0 is 10, 1, and 1, 1, 1, 0 is 14, 1, and 1, 0, 0, 0 is 8, 1. Okay? So how do we combine them? Combine these 4 ones and these 2. Now what is the expression here? So when I combine these 4 ones, I3 and I2 get eliminated because they are in complementary. So I have I2, I0 bar. And what about this? Considering these 2, when I consider these 2 columns, I1 is in complementary, so I have I0 bar. Right? And then I3, I2 bar. So this is the expression for Y0. So what is Y0? So Y0 is so this is I1, I0. So Y0 is I1, I0 bar plus I3, I2 bar, I0 bar. Okay, so combining these 4 ones, the expression is I1, I0 bar. Right, so combining these 4 ones, we have I1, I0 bar because I3 and I2 are in complementary. Now combining these 2 ones, we get I3, I2 bar, I0 bar. I have written the expression here. So now let's try to get the expression for I1. So what is the expression for I1? I1 is 1 for these 2 cases. Right? So x, it can be the 0 or 1, so 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, and then for 1, 0, 0, 0. So y1 is 1 only for these 3 combinations. So this is 4, this is 12, and this is 8. Only for these 3 combinations, y1 is 1. Okay, so I1 is 1 for 0, 1, 0, 0, which is 4 here. I have a 1 here, and then for 1, 1, 0, 0, and for 1, 0, 0, 0. So combining these 2 ones, what do we get? So we get I2, because I3 is in complementary, I1 bar, I0 bar. And then combining these 2 ones, I2 is in complementary, so I have I3, I1 bar, I0 bar. So the expression for Y1 is I2, I1 bar, I0 bar, plus I3, I1 bar, I0 bar. Okay, now what is the expression for valid output? The expression for valid output remains the same as in the previous case where maximum priority was given to I3 and minimum priority to I0. Because It is 0 only for 0, right? For all other cases, it is 1. So we have just seen that in the previous case. So what do we do to get the valid out expression? Combine these 8 ones, combine these 8 ones, these 8 and these 8. So the valid output bit is I3 plus I2 plus I1 plus I0. Okay, so this is how we can design a priority encoder. Here in this case, where maximum priority is given to I0 and minimum priority is given to I3, where we get the expressions for Y0 and Y1 as shown here, and the valid output, which is I0 plus I1 plus I2 plus I3.